Permissions tell us what a user or a group can do with a file or a directory. Can they read the file? Can they execute it? Can they access the directory? If they can't execute the file, how can we change the permissions so they can do so? These are all important questions that you'll need to be able to answer, and I'm gonna give you all the secrets right now. Alrighty, it is demo time. I've got the terminal opened up on my local machine, and I am in a demo directory that I've created. And in here I have file1.txt, file2.txt, and then a script that's called runme. Let's first start off by listing the permissions that these files have. We can use the ls command, which is list, which we used previously to list them out. But now we can use the -l option here that stands for long, and this will provide us a more detailed listing. There's a bunch of columns here as who's the owner of the file or directory, and then who is the group owner of the file or directory, and then the time it was created and the name. But the column that matters to us for this demo is this first one with a bunch of what seems to be random characters. So we have a set of 10 characters here. This first one is going to tell us what is this. Is this a file? Is this a directory? Just tell me what it is. So right now we have this dash, which stands for regular file. Typically you'll see either a dash or a D that stands for directory. So if I were to make a directory inside of here, call it demo2, and then I'll list it out again, you see here we have a D because that's a directory. You might see an L, which stands for symbolic link, or a C, which stands for character special. But typically it'll be regular file, demo, or symbolic link. And now we see, let's take a look at this file1.txt. So we already know that this stands for, hey, this is a file. Next we have 9 characters, and these are actually sort of split into 3 groups of 3. So we have R, which stands for read, W, which stands for write, and then we have a dash. Whenever we have a dash, this means that this specific permission has not been granted. So what is this saying? So if we have in the first 3 characters, this is for the user, the next 3 are the permissions for the group, and the next 3 are permissions for people who aren't the user and who do not belong to the group, so others. So the user has read, write, and no execute. Remember that the dash means no permission. The group has read, write, no execute, and others only have read. And we can see the others are pretty similar, except for this file 2 doesn't have any permissions at all for the other column, right? Okay, let's look at how we can modify permissions. At the moment, I can't actually execute this runme script, even though I own it. You can tell who owns the file by whichever value is in this column here, and in my case, it's me. But if I try to run this script, I'm going to get permission denied. And as you can see, there's no execute permission in here because there's no X value. Specifically, there's no X value in the first 3 characters because this, remember, the first 3 characters are assigned to the user. We can change this using the chmod or change mode command. Then we can say to the user, give them execute permissions. So U plus X, if you wanted it to be the group, you would use G. If you wanted it to be assigned to others, you would use O. And then I'll provide the name of the file. Keep in mind that this command can only be used by the person who owns the file or the root user. So now if I do ls-l once more, you can see that we now have an X in here place where it used to be a dash. So now if I do run, we can see we can actually execute this. Fantastic. But what if we wanted to assign a permission to everyone? So we want everyone to be able to run this script. Well, we can do chmod plus X here, and then the file. And if we do ls dot here, we see that we have an X in each set now. But what if we wanted to remove that? Do we really want everyone to be able to execute this? I don't think so. So we'll do chmod minus X and then run. There we go. Fantastic. Let's do a few more here. Let's allow the others to read file 2. So we can do chmod others plus read file 2.txt. Now let's list that out, and you see we now have an R here. And let's allow others to write to file 1. Let's do chmod others plus W, and we'll do file 1.txt. It's more of a list. Yeah, and then you get the idea. We can add permissions this way, we can remove permissions this way. Just be mindful that you should only use this command when you are absolutely sure about which permissions you are changing. You might end up removing a permission that is required for a process to work, or you might end up adding a permission that will reduce the security of your system.
And that is it for this demo. We've reviewed how to list permissions, change them, remove them, and we understand the responsibility of using the change mode command. Alrighty, Cloud Gurus, that's it for this episode of ACG Fundamentals. Go on and check out the permissions of some files you have on your machine, but be careful. Let us know how it went in the comments of this video. Keep being awesome, and I will see you in the next one.